let's check this out. So I found this this really, really cool little video through Derek Guy, who is a style writer based in New York, I believe. I think he's based in the States. He's got a great blog, Dye Workwear, and he is pretty popping on Twitter too. And he shared this really, really cool little film, which it's got a really cool kind of Sam Uchilis, kind of flair to it, kind of mixing menswear and cinematography. It's quite cool. And this is very, very interesting. So English Silk, the Craft of Hand Block Printing. So this was shot at the David Evans factory in Crayford. And this is 1,000 views. So it's basically an old documentary about the process of silk manufacturing, silk production in England. So it's a pretty cool little video. It's kind of a hilarious thing to be watching, isn't it? It's almost like your roommate's coming on you and you're sitting watching this. It's almost less embarrassing to be watching, legitimately just be watching porn, just be masturbating. Like, nah, dude, I'm not watching 18th century silk videos. But hey, that's kind of the stuff I'm into. So I'm not saying you're gonna sit down and watch the entire thing for an hour and a half, but it's got some cool little scenes. What happened was there's actually some cool little very, very cinematic little scenes, which I think is in line with this kind of episode about Edinburgh and Drake's and stuff. So check out some of these shots.
This area has been a center of weaving for at least 900 years.
You know what I'm saying? Even that, right? You know, the little typography. That could be on a shirt, you know what I mean? That's pretty great. Great color. It's actually very cool. Little serif type on a background of a reflective little black glassy water. Nice little shot there.
It's here that the Derby and Madder handkerchiefs, beloved of Victorian snuff takers, are still printed. The firm's production manager and one of its most experienced block printers is Bob Crane.
Started work with David Evans in 1951, straight from school, washing off pots in the colour house. Most lads couldn't get an apprenticeship as a block printer unless their dad, their uncle, their aunt, or even their mother worked here. But we prepare all our own silk. Everything is boiled out in a very, very hot solution of soap and other chemicals so that it is pure and clean, and what we call virgin silk, time it leaves there. Rinse it thoroughly after we washed it to get rid of all the soap. Any residues left in it will resist colour. Then it's either used in its white state or it's dyed.
Come on, baby. That's giving. It's giving completely Sam Uchilis. It's he posted that. That's getting 50,000 likes. You know, the billowing smoke and the wet fabric and the silhouette of the dude with the glasses. That's feature film.
Indigo. And so he tested it. How can you pass that information on to someone else? He was teaching a lad to do it. He knew the basics. But you imagine all of a sudden the man...
This is a pretty great shot here. Really like this. This feels quite... this is a nice abstract kind of reflection. That's quite nice.
Dye from the madder root was used for the wrappings of Egyptian mummies and is one of the oldest methods of dyeing known to man.
Right, I mean, how good is this? My colors are a bit messed up because I've changed the display on my screen, but you know, it's like Willy Wonka Chocolate Factory esque, isn't it? You know, these kind of bright fluorescent gloves with the, you know, the off white kind of it's almost like a cake batter, right? It's not cake batter; it's a silk kind of chemical, but yeah, it's cool colors. You know, what I mean, cool textures and stuff. It's pretty cool.
There is nothing haphazard in the blending of the colors. Constant accuracy is needed to repeatedly mix the same shades.
How good is that? That's very, very sweet. I forgot how cool that shot was. Silhouette going in and out of shadows, and he's got this great handwritten typography identification labeling system behind him. That's fantastic. And he's in this cool kind of long coat tweed, right? That's really cool.
...of the enormous library of hand printing blocks. The earliest blocks at David Evans were brought over to England from the continent. Some were part of a ransom which the French dispatched on a raft to England in exchange for money to pay the Prussians to lift the siege of Paris.
Well, these are all silk hand-printed blocks that he's going through. Very cool.
Deep in my heart, I'm still a block printer. I love it. But economics is one again. We run by accountants now, not by craftsmen. David Evans' library of block designs consists of something in excess of 70,000 blocks, totaling some.
Yeah, I thought this was quite a poetic shots. You know, the cobwebs on the window frame and this really great typography, which is kind of distorted at this angle. That's quite nice.
An offshoot of the River Cray passes through the factory and is invaluable for washing the silk, a major reason why the factory was built here.
So yeah, man, you get the idea. Derek Guy is a cool little journalist, and he put us onto that. So yeah, cool little piece, and it's cool to learn about. I don't remember all the little technical details, but silk itself is a really interesting material. I think the bugs themselves, or silk itself, came from China way back when, and it's a super, super intensive process that they do a really, really good job explaining. So yeah, appreciated that. That's actually, that was even cooler than I remember. It's got a really cool kind of Sam Uchilis, kind of flair to it, kind of mixing menswear and cinematography. It's quite cool.